Consider the function f of x equals x squared. What I first want to do is compute the derivative of x squared, and we're going to do this from the definition. So remind ourselves what the definition of the derivative is. The derivative is the function f prime of x, which for any value x, it's going to be the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. That's one version of the derivative. Another version that more resembles the slope formula is you take the limit as, say, b approaches x of, well, f of b minus f of x all over b minus x. And so either one of these versions is perfectly fine. In this video, I'm going to approach this one right here, this more traditional slope approach. Typically speaking, I would say this one with the h is a little bit easier, but again, for the sake of this video, I'm going to approach the second one there. So if we use the specific function f in this situation, our derivative f prime of x is going to look like the limit as b approaches x. We're going to get f of b, which is going to be b squared, minus f of x, which is x squared. And this sits above b minus x. So like I said, if we just plug in x equals b, we're going to get 0 over 0. Not much we can do with that except for the hope that there is something better we could do. Instead, what we need to do here is we're going to factor the numerator. The reason that we get 0 over 0 is because these two polynomials, b squared minus x squared and b minus x, have a common factor. The numerator is actually a difference of squares. We get b minus x and we get b plus x on the top. Then there's a b minus x in the denominator. We see that the factor of b minus x on top cancels with the factor of b minus x in the bottom. And so this ratio would simplify just to be b plus x, again, as b approaches x right here. Now that we've removed the discontinuity here, we can allow b to become x. So we end up with x plus x, which is equal to 2x. So this is the derivative of x squared. The derivative of x squared is 2x. Well, what does this 2x actually measure then? So recall our function f of x is itself x squared, the parabola, the standard parabola, which you see on the screen illustrated here in yellow. We discover that its derivative f prime of x is equal to 2x. So what this is telling us is that if we pick any coordinate in the domain, any x coordinate in the domain of the function, and we look at the associated tangent line at that point, the slope of the tangent line will just be 2 times the x coordinate. That's what we're trying to measure here. And so let's look at some specific examples. Let's calculate f prime at 3 and find out what the tangent line of f at x equals 3 would be. Well, now that we've already computed the derivative, computing f prime of 3 is going to be a cinch, right? Because we just have to take f prime of 3, which by the formula is 2 times 3, which is equal to 6. This tells us that the slope of the tangent line at x equals 3 is going to be 6. So in general, a tangent line is going to look like y minus f of the value, in this case it's 3, then it's going to equal f prime of that value, and again 3, and you minus, or times by x minus 3 right here. So in general, your slope intercept form, or your slope point form, excuse me, y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, where x1, y1 are a specific point on the line for the line, the tangent line, the point of tangency is the only point we know on the line right now. And then the slope is the derivative. The slope of the tangent line is the evaluation of the derivative because the derivative gives you the formula for the tangent line here. And so plug in the values we know. We get y minus f of 3. F of 3, you're going to take 3 squared. You get a 9. And then f prime of 3, we saw was 6. X minus 3 right here. So distribute the 6. We get 6x minus 18. We're then going to proceed to add 9 to both sides of the equation. We end up with y equals 6x minus 9, for which you can see on the graph exactly that right here. Here's our point 3, 9 on the graph. Illustrated in green is the tangent line. And sure enough, when we take the slope to be 6 and the y-intercept to be negative 3, we get the correct tangent line for the graph. Notice how it's just barely touching, just kissing the function there at the point 3, 9. Let's look at another example. Let's find the tangent line again of y equals x squared when x equals 1 this time. Well, so we have to look at y minus f of 1 is equal to f prime at 1 times x minus 1. We just got to fill in the blanks right here. Well, if you take 1 squared, you're going to get a 1. If you take 2 times 1, which is what the derivative does here, you're going to get a 2 times that by x minus 1. Distribute the 2, we get 2x minus 2. And then we have to add 1 to both sides. at 1, excuse me. And therefore, the tangent line is going to look like y equals 2x minus 1, which then let's check with our illustration right here. If you can see the point of tangency to be 1, 1. The y-intercept, yeah, that seems like that could be negative 1. The y-scale is distorted a little bit. This distance right here is 5, while this one here is a 1. But we do see this exact kissing tangent line right there, which we found. The critical part of finding the tangent line, the hard part, is going to come from the slope. And we get the tangent slope by computing the derivative and evaluating the derivative at the specific number.